Antibiotics are chemical substances which are produced by certain microorganisms and which can influence the growth of bacteria. It may happen that the bacteria are just inhibited. This happens in case of bacteriostatic antibiotics. Furthermore, it is possible that the bacteria are killed, either in the way that the cells stay intact when dealing with a bactericidal antibiotic, or in the way that the cells are lysed after addition of a bacteriolytic antibiotic. In the experiment, three different antibiotics will be tested and classified. We will use ampicillin, chloramphenicol, and streptomycin. For setting up the pre-culture, one needs the following material: the test organism grown on a suitable auger, sterile Müller-Hinton broth, a sterile cylinder 50 ml, and a sterile 250 ml flask. For the preparation of the test culture, a sterile 250 ml cylinder and a 500 flask, again both sterile of course. Additionally, we need sterile stoppers, an inoculating loop, and a Bunsen burner. Please note that we will inoculate in a laminar flow and therefore we use disposable inoculating loops instead of. As soon as the sterilium is distributed and dried, one can start working in the hood. First, the required medium volumes will be measured. Afterwards, the medium is transferred into the different flasks. And finally, the pre-culture is inoculated. Flasks will now be brought onto the shaker at 37 degrees, where they incubate overnight. At the next morning, the test culture will be set up. Before we can start, we need to have the following material handy: the pre-ground test culture, a vortex, sterile 10 ml glass pipettes, a container with disinfectant for the pipettes, sterile 25 ml flasks and sterile stoppers, the antibiotics on ice, a standard pipette for 100 microliter in sterile yellow tips, a small biohazard bag, a standard pipette for 1000 microliters in sterile blue tips, cuvettes, and a timer. First, a small volume of the sterile medium is removed and placed into the blank cuvette. Afterwards, the test culture is inoculated by using the pre-culture. For this purpose, the pre-culture must be vortexed very intensively. Before one can add the antibiotics to the culture, one must pre-grow the test culture. For the control of this pre-growth, one measures from time to time the optical density. The first sample will be taken directly after inoculation. While the culture gets onto the shaker, the measurement will be done. First, the blank must be set, therefore one sets a cuvette with the sterile medium into the photometer and sets it on zero. Afterwards, the sample cuvette can be measured. After a defined time, the next measurement will be done. When the OD proves sufficient growth, one can aliquot the test culture and the experiment can finally start. Now the antibiotics must be added to the cultures. Directly after the addition, the culture will be vortexed to distribute the antibiotic nicely in the medium. As soon as all antibiotics are added, the cultures will be vortexed again and sampled for the first optical density measurement will be taken out. the cultures will be placed onto the shaker. The timer will be set and the measurement at 0 minutes will be done. As we always reuse the cuvettes, the incubation time will be used for cleaning the cuvettes directly. First you pour the content into the biohazard bag, then you rinse dry with water, afterwards excess liquid must be removed. So it goes on for the next 2 hours, and step by step the data sheet with the measurements will be filled and the graphic is prepared. After the incubation of 2 hours, one goes to the next step, the cultivation of the cells in absence of the antibiotics. For this part we need the following things: a rack for Eppendorf tubes and sterile 1.5 ml Eppendorf tubes, sterile sodium chloride in a concentration of 0.75%. A standard pipe at 1000 microliter and sterile blue tips. A small biohazard bag. The cultures. A vortex. A standard pipette, this time for 100 microliter, sterile yellow tips. A microfuge. 5 sterile Müller-Hinton agar plates. Sterile Drygalski spatula. And a container with disinfectant for the spatula. First, one must transfer 0.9 ml sodium chloride into sterile test tubes. To be honest, this preparation can already be done during one of the incubation periods before. Now you are adding 0.1 ml of the cultures to your test tubes. The samples will be now centrifugated. Therefore, the test tubes will be placed in a balanced manner into the rotor. Speed and time will be adjusted, and then the centrifugation can start. After the centrifugation, the supernatant will be removed. First, the supernatant is simply poured into the biohazard bag. Afterwards, the remaining liquid will be removed by taking a small standard pipette. Now the pellet must be resuspended by adding sodium chloride and while mixing. The samples are now prepared and can be inoculated onto the Müller-Hinton plates. This is done by using the spray plate method, but of course first the plates must be labeled. After the inoculation, the plates will be placed into the incubator at 37 degrees. After an overnight incubation, the results will be examined.